This is important in item number 6, is not to seek feelings. When I have put together the lessons in this program on the different research designs specifically for a case study in phenomenology, I've indicated do not seek feelings when you're asking people questions. When you're interviewing them, stay away from feelings unless you are a psychologist or you're in a psychology program and you're being led by faculty who are psychologists. Most people who are not psychologists do not have the wherewithal, meaning the knowledge and the skills to assess feelings correctly. Feelings are a little murky in the sense that it's not as clearly identifiable as perhaps a lived experience is if you're asking for somebody's assumptions, beliefs, or perceptions. Oftentimes, people use the word feelings incorrectly when they mean what their assumptions are, what their experiences were. So as you start to do more with qualitative research, and whether it's going to be from mentoring people or you're going to be doing your own research, whether it be in an academic setting as a student or in the corporate environment, keep in mind, what do you want to learn from people? Do you really want to know what they feel? In a psychology-based program, more than likely you do, because that's what psychology often deals with, is the feelings of people, where more times than not in non-psychology programs, we're not looking for feelings, but we're looking for what they did, what they thought about it. There's a difference between what people think and what they feel.